السلام عليكم. إذا الساوند أون ودي؟ هلو؟
هلو؟ يس.
أوكي.
يا، your audio is clear. We can
hear you. Yes, it's clear.
Actually, we still have time. 23 minutes left. Welcome all the participants. Thank you for joining today. We still have time, so we are waiting for more participants to join. Thank you. And please see the screen. Here is the settings. If anybody face any challenge to hear the audio of the speaker. Hi, Elizabeth.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good afternoon.
It is also a good evening. Thank you. Just for testing, can you hear my voice clear?
Very clear.
Yeah.
Am I audible? And
yeah, well, your voice is perfectly clear. Perfectly clear.
Thank you.
Mr. Sable, can you please do a test with Elizabeth?
Definitely. Hi, Eliza.
Good evening, Mr. Sybil. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Very well. Your voice is very much audible and wish you all the best.
Okay. Thank you very much, Elizabeth. And we have got some time to start.
Yes, yes, yes. We will start at 5 p.m. sharp. Indian time.
Yeah, definitely, definitely.
Sure.
Salam, sir. Thank you for joining. We will begin shortly. We still have time of 5 minutes. Let's wait for some more participants to join.
ठंडे कपड़े हो गए, पता
नहीं चल रहा है। थोड़े माइंड में तो पता चल गया। गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, वी रिक्वेस्ट ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स टू प्लीज कीप योर माइक्स ऑन म्यूट. Because it is disturbing. When the moderator will ask you to unmute, then you can use this option.
Good evening, everyone. Before I start, I would want a representative from Alvin to confirm if I'm audible and visible both.
Hi, good evening, Elizabeth. Yes, your voice is clear and video is very clear. I can hear you and see. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Again, once again, hello everyone. Good evening. Salaam alaikum and namaste. Wishing a
good evening.
Thank you. Wishing a very happy new year and a bright 2021 to you and your families. Thank you all for joining us today. My name is Elizabeth George. I'm a learning and development professional with an experience in hospitality, BPO, and the retail sector. I will be your host for today. I welcome you all to our ISO knowledge sharing webinar series. And today's session is based on ISO 14001 2015 EMS, How to Conduct Environmental Impact Assessment by Mr. Saibal Gupta, our guest speaker for today. Sharing a brief introduction of Alvin Integrated Services for the benefit of all participants who have joined us today. Alvin Integrated Services is a leading training and certification support provider company from India in continuity, development, and resilience. AIS has a vision to exist together in the future with our clients by sharing our knowledge with them and to be a leader in the industry. Today's session is being conducted by Mr. Saibal Gupta. Mr. Saibal is a senior advisor and consultant at Alvin Integrated and an electrical engineer with 39 plus years technical working experience and 14 years ISO auditing experience. He also holds the prestigious position of personal trainer at Tresert, Germany, a renowned certification body. What we would be covering in the webinar today is elements of environmental impact assessment, difference between SEA and EIA, steps of EIA, main feature to be covered in EIA, benefits and objective of EIA, factors to be considered in EIA. Before moving on, I would like to mention a special note to all our attendees. Please feel free to ask any questions during the session by dropping them in the chat box. Our speaker will be answering them towards the end of the session or in between as well if the need arises. Now, I would invite Mr. Saibal to enlighten us with his knowledge of the industry. Over to you, Mr. Saibal.
Thank you, Elizabeth. Thank you for your words. And welcome, everyone. Today, we'll learn about ISO 14001 2015 standard EMS, how to conduct the environmental impact assessment. As you know, in ISO 14001-2015, a key process is the study of aspects to find the or assess the impact caused by those aspects. Environmental impact assessment is a process of evaluating the likely environmental impacts on any organization, projects, or development program, taken into account the interrelated socio-economic, cultural, and human health, both adverse and beneficial. EIA is a study to evaluate and identify the predictable environmental consequences and the best combination of cost and benefits of the proposed project. Environmental impact assessment can also be termed as environmental assessment. Positive or negative environmental consequences of a plan program prior to move forward with a proposed action plan. The environmental impact assessment is closely related, or you can say correlated, with the strategic environmental assessment. Without strategic environmental assessment, which is called SEA, one organization or anyone cannot do the environmental impact assessment. EIA is usually used for strategic direction environmental assessment, forming a part of the decision-making process by any organization. It can be used for the project approval. It can be used for the decision-making, any administrative procedure, impact consideration, and the mitigating the physical, social, and other effects. SEA, that strategic environmental assessment, is a proactive and sustainability-driven process. It might be up to entire sector organization in a particular geographical area, and EIA is a reactive and helps to streamline and focus on environmental concern. The key elements of EIA is the screening, scoping, assessment, evaluation of impact, development of alternatives, environmental impact statement. Now, what is the difference between the EIA and SEA? The environmental impact assessment of projects is a technical instrument related to activities with geographic and technical specification. It is a reactive approach. It is used at the end of the decision-making process. EIA identifies the specific impact in the environment. It is a limited review of cumulative effects. And it emphasizes on the mitigating and minimizing the impacts of the aspects determined. And the strategic environment assessment is a political instrument related to concepts. It is a proactive approach, and it is applied, this strategic environment assessment is applied the earlier stages of a decision-making process of a project or an organization. It addresses issues of sustainable development. It gives the early warning of the cumulative effects. You can, if you go for a strategic environmental assessment, then you can get a warning, the what impact is, can be there. It is a study of prevention in terms of identified environmental it is most strategic, and the EIA is the most detailed study. The essential components of the EIA, that environmental impact assessment, first, it is divided into seven steps. The first step is the screening. Screening means to determine whether the projects required a full or partial impact assessment. Either it requires a full assessment or a partial assessment on a particular part of a project. The scoping, secondary scoping. Scoping is to identify which potential impacts are relevant to assess, to identify the alternative solution, avoid or mitigate or compensate the adverse impact on the biodiversity, and finally to derive terms of reference for the impact assessment. Third point, the steps is the assessment and evaluation of the impacts and development of the alternatives. To predict and identify the likely environmental impact of a proposed project or a development activity, including the detailed elaboration of the alternatives available. After this assessment and evaluation of a project, the reporting, the environmental impact statement, which is called the EIS or EIA report, to be submitted to the authority. It must be included with an environmental management plan that is called the EMP. After submitting to the authority, the review of the environmental impact statement, that is EIS, along with the EIA, based on the terms of reference, that scoping, and the public, including the authority, and their participation. After review of this EIS and EIA report, and public opinion and scoping, the decision making whether to approve the project or not, or it is under, if it is rejected, under what condition it can be rejected, it should be taken care of. And if the project is approved, then monitoring compliance of enforcements, legal, and the environmental auditing to be done with a monitoring mechanism whether the predicted importance and the proposed mitigation measures occurs as defined as in environmental management program. As I told that there is seven steps of EIA. The screening, when you go for a new project or a development project, the screening determines the environmental and social impact, whether it is significant enough to develop a EIA on that project. If not, if it is not required, that EIA, because EIA is a detailed assessment of the environmental aspects in terms of its impact. If not, then an environmental management program to be created and monitored regularly. The scoping is the boundary of the EIA in consultation with the affected public. In and around a project, many human or biodiversity or any affecting the public to be taken into account, discussion with the public, meeting with the public about the project is to be done. The impact is the assessment and mitigation plan, which evaluates the socio-economic environmental impacts and identify the mitigation measures to reduce the impacts could be occurred by the aspects. Then it is required an impact management program. It prepares the plan to address the mitigation measures and others' risk. Then EIA report. You can call it either EIA report or EIS, that environmental impact statement. In the EIA report, all the work, all the studies, all the assessments and evaluation and other managements to be done through a structured documentation that ensures the EIA contains all key components. Review and licensing. After submitting the EIA report to the authority, the competent authority is to review the EIA report to determine the clearance of the project or any amendment is required for that project. If approved, the monitoring is a process which ensures the mitigation measures, priorities in EMP, and the other contingencies plan are properly implemented and effectively addressed to the project impacts. When you go for the environmental impact assessment, there is three type of sciences is to be taken care of. One is earth science, second is life science, and third is social science. In earth science, the climate, the air, water, soils, and geology is to be taken care of. In the life science, the terrestrial ecology, aquatic ecology, and in social science, the landscape or geographic location, humans, and cultural heritage is to be taken care of when you go for an environmental impact assessment. Different type of environmental impacts are the impacts on soil, water, it can be groundwater, it can be surface water, air quality, impact on land, forest, agriculture, fisheries, tourism, recreation, etc. The socio-economic impact, short or long time impact on pollution, impact on health, impact on flora, fauna, wildlife, endemic, and integrated spices. EMP covers the following aspects: the safeguard and control measure proposed for mitigation of adverse effect, plans for habitation contingency plan to deal with the accidents and disasters, monitoring and feedback mechanism on the implementation. So friend, before going further, I'd like to ask you if you have any question or any doubt, you can ask me, unmuting yourself by our moderator, Miss Elizabeth George.
Thank you, Mr. Saibal. I guess it's a nice break in between to understand if our valuable audience needs to ask any question. I can see Bashir. I think Bashir has a question to ask. Bashir, would you like to ask right now so that it can be answered? Would you like to unmute yourself and come on screen? Okay, I have not got an answer. Is there anyone else who has any questions
anyway,
right now, or shall we continue?
Sorry, yes, sorry, Elizabeth. You hear me? Hello.
Yes. I can hear you.
Yeah. Good morning for everyone. First of all, I will thank you and Mr. Alvin for the presentation, and it's a pleasure to attend it with you. I have some questions as I'm working in the oil and gas, okay? Mr., is the two studies, EIA and CIA, are an obligation to start for any project, or we have a choose, we start by each one?
Well, that EIA or SEA, it can be done for a new project, also for a development project for extension of any facilities or any type of extra work or extra construction. If you are going for this, then that SEA and EIA to be made, but you have to take in care that whether that EIA is required for that particular project or not. You have to assess by the first is the boundary, that is scoping. What I have told earlier, and is the screening process. I think you got your answer properly.
Mr. Bashir, did you get the answer that you were looking out for?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Thanks,
thank
sir.
You. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Bashir. Thank you for putting that across.
Thanks a lot. I have another.
Mr. Saibal, we have 2-3 questions more. Would you like to answer them now, or would you like to continue?
So, I would like to answer one question now.
Okay, so I guess Kingsley is already, Mr. Kingsley Michael has unmuted himself and he has a question. I'll repeat, Mr. Kingsley Michael had a question. In case he's not unmuting, what he's written in the chat box is, who conducts EIA?
Who is responsible to carry out environmental impact assessment? Is it the environmental engineer in charge of the project, or who?
No, with support of the top management or the management of the project, the environmental committee. Sir, there is a please unmute yourself. Elizabeth, ask participant to unmute.
I can only request participants to mute themselves, please. Or if, thank you. Yes, Mr. Saibal, please continue.
Yes, the environmental manager is a environmental management team or environmental engineer. In the organization is the responsible for the EIA assessment in with the support of the top management because the after this EIA decision making process by the top management arises. I hope you got your answer.
Mr. Kingsley,
hello.
Is your doubt Mr. clear?
Hello. Actually, my question is this. An organization that hired a new environmental engineer to work on a new project without experience, how then will this guy be able to carry out environmental impact assessment if he is working independently?
So, if you are working, again, some background talking is there because Mr. Kingsley has raised a question I couldn't answer because of the noise.
He's muted himself, Mr. Saibal. If you...
Okay. Well, Mr. Kingsley, if this guy has doesn't have any experience for that organization they are working, they have got the environmental engineer or the environmental assessment team because that EIA is required for the approval. Without EIA report, one project approval couldn't be done by the government authority for any country. The environmental impact is to be assessed by collectively with the organization. If the your question is the if a guy is inexperienced to conduct the EIA, so he can take the help of the main organization, mother organization, environmental engineers, and got some training for the how to conduct the environmental impact assessment in respect to the aspect determined by the organization. So, Mr. Kingsley, I think that you got your answer. So, let us move further. So, next point in our webinar is the human exposure assessment location. It is called the HEAL or HEAL. This concept is applied for the EIA assessment techniques. This concept is developed for three components, the air quality monitoring, water quality monitoring, and food quality monitoring. Why this is called the human exposure assessment location? Because the air, water, and food is closely related or correlated with the human being, those who are working for the projects. And the public hearing. Public hearing is a must do act because if a project develops or a government appropriate project, so the study of the human effect on that project. After EIA report, it is a mandatory clause or mandatory law to require that the public, the benefited local or affected local, local association, environment groups, or any other affected persons may be informed or consulted on the proposed project or work or project before going to the approval stage or any construction. So what is the benefits of the EIA? The benefits of the EIA is the EIA, if you go for a EIA study, EIA reduce the cost and time of implementation. Because with the EIA, you can identify the aspects and its impact. So timely action can be taken and the cost reduction as well can be implemented. The cost saving modification in any project design, if you are going for a modification in any project, the EIA will be helpful for your cost saving. It helps in increased project acceptance by the authority, avoided the impacts and the violation of laws and regulation, because when you go for a EIA study, you have to abide by the local laws and regulations imparted by the country of operation. It improves the performance of the persons or performance of the organization. And it avoids the treatment cost as well. The objective of EIA review, after EIA, you have to review the EIA, whether it is well-framed or whether it is viable for that particular project. So objective of the EIA to identify the impacts and to predict the impact as well. If you identify the impact, you can predict the impact, the result of the, if there is any impact, what will be the results? You can evaluate the economic, social, and environmental impacts. The objective of EIA is to provide environmental consequences. In which consequences the impact can be significant or whether it is non-significant. It provides the environmentally sound and sustainable development to a organization. When you go for the EIA, you have to go for with a environmental policy, the organizational environmental policy, the ecosystem management, then the protection of natural resources like water, forest, wildlife, etc. And also in your environmental policy, the preservation of wildlife is to be there. The techniques and methods of the waste management, air, water pollution, and the monitoring of sound, it should be taken care of, and the biodiversity protection to be there in a EIA. Now, after EIA, you have to one organization have to submit the EIS to the authority for approval or approval of the project. So EIA should be content with the description of the proposed action and selection of alternatives in case of if there is any significant impact. So EIS will be possible, will be contained with the possibility of the natural disaster, either cyclone, earthquake, and flood, etc. If that happens, what is the mitigation plan? The nature and magnitude of the likely environmental effect. The project impact effects on the ground and surface water quality, air quality, and the soil quality. The effect on the vegetation, wildlife, endemic, and endangered species. The noise pollution due to that new project or development projects. Identification of the relevant human concern, economic and demography factors is to be taken care of, recycling and reduction of waste, and risk analysis and disaster management. All these points to be covered in the EIS report to be submitted to the authority. Now, this EIA, Environmental Impact Assessment, is governed by the 8 guiding principles. First is the participation by the interested party. Who is the interested party? I think you all know the interested party, our organization, stakeholders, shareholders, public, government, and other regulatory bodies, all are our interested party, including our family. The EIS is guided by the transparency principle. It is also guided by the certainty principle, accountability principle, who is accountable for this. Like Mr. Kingsley has asked the question, who will be responsible? Who is the accountable? In any organization, the top management is accountable for this setting up this principle for that particular organization. EIA is guided by the cost effectiveness principle, flexibility, principle of flexibility, and principle of practicality. Now, Mr. Kingsley has asked this question, who are the responsible? This is the participants of the EIA. Who will conduct the EIA? The proponent. Who proposed the project? The decision maker, either the top management of the organization or the government approval authority is the decision maker whether this project is to be approved or rejected. The assessor of the EIA and the reviewer, after assessing by persons, there will be a review of this EIA, whether the assessment has been gone correct or not. Now, Now we come to the EIA process in sequence of application. How this is applicable? As I told earlier, the stakeholders implement involvement to ensure quality, efficiency, and effectiveness is required. The screening, whether this project is required EIA or no EIA, or partial EIA. And the scoping is the boundary of the EIA to determine the necessity of EIA, whether it is necessary for a go for a EIA study, and to set screening criteria, scope, coverage, and boundary of the EIA. Project design and construction to ensure the type of the projects. Physical dimension of area are being considered in any project. What the project is critical phase or a larger development, whether there will be any serious environmental disruption due to this project. Not only in the implementation phase, it also to be considered as a long term in the operation phase also. The project operation is to ensure that the provision to check the safety equipments regularly, how the hazardous waste being handled, what are the contingencies plan to cope up with the possible accidents, training of employees for environmental protection, and a monitoring plan. The process is to find out the possible environmental impacts. What are the short-term and long-term impacts? A aspects can be very short-term, and one aspects can be very long-term aspects. I will give you just an example of this short-term and long-term impact after this slide, and who the people will be affected by this impact. Mitigation measure to ensure the system design to reduce, avoid, minimize the adverse impact to enhance the beneficial outcomes. So I was in the previous point, the possible environmental impacts. I think you all are known about the Bhopal gas tragedy, where the lakhs of persons were died. The report says that the proper EIA, when the setting of the Union Carbide factory in Bhopal, densely populated area, has been taken up, the proper EIA has not been conducted. So when you go for a EIA, the long-term impact on the surroundings or environment or human being is to be taken care of. The monitoring and auditing measure of the EIA is to ensure the identified impacts needs to be monitored and audited. If you go for the audit, it will be very beneficial for an organization. The gap analysis can be made available with the management. the socioeconomic factors to ensure the expected gainer, loser, or expected trade-offs interface between the existing inequalities to be calculated. Availability of information and resources. The EIA report and its review. The decision making by the authority or the top management of the organization. It is to be taken care of the whether the importance of EIA is required, whether it is viable to go for a EIA or not. The potentially useful for good environmental management. It is a government policy that any project has to obtain EIA clearance from the environmental competent authority like pollution control boards or Ministry of Pollution Control. This is the process flow of the EIA. There is a 6-step. When you go for the environmental impact assessment, you all know the PDCA cycle. Here it comes the PDCA cycle. Step one is the site selection, in which site the project is going to implement it, and the conduct of EIA. Step one and two is the planning stage. And as you know, PDCA cycle of ISO framework, the apply for no objection certificate to the authority. It is a D. It is called the do. And step four is the either state or National Pollution Control Board arrange for the public hearing, which is most important for a upcoming project or a development project in and around a locality. The public hearing, the affected person to be consulted about the projects and the pros and cons of the project to be discussed with the public. And the step five, after public hearing or pollution control board arranges for the public hearing, the application for the environmental clearance with EIA report and the NOC from the pollution control board, etc., to be submitted to the authority. Number six and end point is the review of the environmental appraisal committee, whether it is this project is to be approved or rejected or be any changes suggested. If they suggest any changes, then again the from step two, you have to go again up to step six. So here is the process flowchart in details. The first is the proposal identification. Then proposal identification is come through the screening. The screening will determine whether the EIA is required or not required. If this is required, then if this is not required, then nothing to be done. The initial examination of environmental is to be done. If it is EIA is required, then this scoping, this is the boundary of what will be the boundary of the EIA, the impact analysis, the mitigation impact management will be there. Then EIA report or EIS report review of the EIA report. After review, this the decision making, whether it is approved or not. If it is approved, the implementation and post-EIA monitoring is to be done. If decision, if in the phase of the decision-making phase, if it is not approved, then again the redesign it and resubmit it for the approval. Now come to the public involvement. If the EIA is required, the public involvement or public hearing is needed for the scoping stage. Sorry, in the scoping stage and the review stage. Here is the two points where the public hearing or public involvement is required. The public involvement typically occurs at these two points. It may also occur in that any other stage of the EIA process. So what is screening? I will now go for some elaboration of the every steps of the EIA. So EIA is a first steps is the screening. These steps determines whether or not EIA is required for a particular project. What level of EIA is required? What is the degree of the level the EIA is required? When you go for the screening outcome, what is the screening outcome? After doing the screening, the full or comprehensive EIA required or not? Or either limited EIA is required or no EIA is required. You can find it out in the screening process. Then come to the scoping. It begins once the screening is completed. The most important steps in EIA is to be determined in the scoping process. It helps to establish the content and the scope of an EIA report. The scoping outcome is to identify the key issues and impacts to be considered, lays the foundation of an effective process, save time and money, and the reduce the conflicts. Here is the four facts of the environment. One is the physical and chemical environment. Second is the biological environment. Third is the human or economic environment. And fourth is the human or social environment. That human are involved in the economic environment as well as in social environment. This is the main four facts of the environment. Now, how the impact analysis is defined? The type of the impact analysis, whether it is biophysical, social, or health, or economic type of analysis is to be conducted. The nature of the analysis, it is either direct nature of analysis or indirect or cumulative. In this impact analysis, the magnitude of the severity is to be determined, whether it is high, moderate, or low. The extent of the boundary, local, regional, and transboundary or global impact is there. the timing, whether it is short-term analysis for a short-term impact or for a long-term impact. The duration of this impact analysis, whether it is temporary or the permanent duration. The uncertainty assessment will be there, whether it is a low likelihood or high probability. If it occurs frequently, then it is to be termed as a high probability. And if it is very rare or very not very severe, it can be termed as a low likelihood. Then reversibility, reversible or irreversible, whether this impact can be reversed. And significance, whether the significance is important or unimportant. Where the significance is the important, this must be taken, must be given a high priority of this significant mitigation plan. The impact mitigation, after this impact analysis, the impact, what is the outcome of the impact mitigation? The impact mitigation is that to avoid or minimize or remedy the adverse impact or transfer. To ensure that the residual impact are within the acceptable level or acceptable limit. To enhance the environmental and social benefits. So here come the reporting stage. The EIA report can have that different name. It can be termed as the EA, as I earlier told that EA, that environmental assessment or environmental impact analysis report, or EIS. It can be defined as a different name. EIA report, environmental impact assessment report, or environmental impact statement, or environmental statements, environmental assessment report, EA report, or environmental effect statement, EES. The contents of this report, what should contain in this report? A detailed description of the project, an outline of the main alternative studies, by the developer, by the projector, and the indication of the main reasons of this choice, why this has been chosen for a project. A description of the aspects of the environment likely to be significantly affected the proposed project or not. So all the description of the aspects identified to contain in a report. Then after contents of the report, the measure to prevent, reduce, and possibility offset adverse environmental effect must be there. The recommend, that means the measurement of the prevention, recommendation to reduce, or the possibly offset of mitigate the adverse environmental effect should be there in a report. A non-technical summary, an indication of any difficulties, the technical deficiencies or lack of know-how, or encountered where the complying with the required information is to be there in the report. After submitting the EIA report to the authority, next comes the review of the EIA report for decision making and approval. The approver will review, the reviewer will review the EIA report about the quality of the report, whether this EIA is taken, the all the aspects of that project and impact analysis has been made for the all the aspects identified. Next, the in the review, the public opinion, public comments to be taken into account. Reviewer is to determine that if the information is the sufficient for submitting the report to the reviewer for decision making for the approval authority. Identify any deficiencies to be corrected. If reviewer finds any deficiency is in the assessor's report of EIA, then it is to be corrected before submitting for the decision-making process. And then now comes to the decision-making, to provide key input to help the determine if the proposal is acceptable. That means the in EIA report, the key inputs about the project to be there. It is to help establish environmental terms and conditions for the project implementation by the organization is proposing the project. If the decision-making authority or approver approves the project, then comes the monitoring. Monitoring of for this project approval is to be taken regularly, ensure the implementation of the condition attached to a decision is properly done, verify the impacts are predictable and permitted, the confirm that the mitigation measures are working as expected in the EIA report, and take action to manage any unforeseen changes made to the either in the project or in the EIA report. If there is any changes, the EIA report must be again sent to the approval authority for their clearance and decision-making purpose. The public involvement in the EIA step, it is the most important part of any type of project EIA steps. The consult the public likely to be affected by the proposal. Suppose one road project is going on within a locality. There may be some houses or some field which the farmers are working and they earn the bread and butter for this road. That public, these farmers and local habitats and local people is to be considered by decision makers with the public hearing is a must do act in the EIA steps. To ensure that significant issues are identified for the project, The project related information is gathered in all with the all sources, and all the alternatives are considered for any type of impact or significant impact. To avoid biases and inaccuracy in analysis is to be a main steps. Identify the local values, local preferences, assist in the consideration of mitigation measures, select the best alternative to mitigate the impacts. The reviewer comments are mandatory on the EIA report. To monitor the implement of EIA reports, recommendation and decision condition is to be taken care of. Now we come to towards the end of this session, the impact analysis, environmental impact analysis. This webinar has provided a useful overview to our honorable participants for the majority of the EIA process, generally taken care of, and techniques of the EIA process. I would like to recommend the feedback on this webinar from the participant and apply this learning outcome to their own project or own organization, to apply these techniques and processes of environmental impact analysis to their organization to satisfy the situation in and around them. Thank you. Here I comes to the end of this webinar, and over to Elizabeth George for any question.
Thank you so much, Mr. Saibal, for sharing your deep knowledge, your vast experience. It was quite insightful, and I'm sure it was helpful to all our participants. Now, before I continue with the question answer session, I have a quick announcement for all the participants. I would request all of you to rename yourself properly for the participation certificates and the attendance. So just put in your full name. If you could rename yourself, that will help the team at AIS to prepare your participation certificates properly. While we do that, Mr. Saibal, we will continue with the question answer session. And there were a few questions which were in the chat box, so I think we would start with that. Will that be fine, Mr. Saibal?
Yes, you can ask a question.
So the first one is from Mr. Gopal Kumar Jha. If the question is still not answered, Mr. Gopal, would you like to come on screen, unmute yourself? Okay, the question that he had written was, how to make an environmental impact report. So would you like to add in more information, Mr. Saibal? It was written in between the session.
Yeah. Good. How to...
I'll repeat. What? How to make an environmental impact report.
Yes. As I told in this... knowledge sharing session, the report should contain the every aspects of the project, right from the screening, the whether EIA is required or not. If this EIA is required, then the scope, what is the boundary of the EIA? It should be contained in the EIA report. After that, scoping, that impact analysis will be there. So each and every impact analysis, impact or whether it is significant or non-significant, the mitigation plan, side by side, it there should be there. The for this, suppose one chemical plant is discharging some chemical to the mainstream of the water. So mitigation plan, that chemical can mix up with the natural water, and after drinking this water, the animals and people can get a adverse health effect. So it is required a mitigation plan before discharging this chemical mixed water to the mainstream. It should be treated, and its pH value to be under the normal condition specified by the pollution control board or the regulatory authority. All this, and the effect of biodiversity, effect on the, as I told, that human factors is to be taken care of, the economic factor is to be taken care of, the in this EIA report, all the elements to be included for the approval of a project or the development approval of a project. Otherwise, there is a mere very good chance to reject by the regulatory board.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Saibal. The question after that was by Mr. Pradeep Nair. He is in the meeting. Would you like to unmute yourself, Mr. Nair, and ask the question? Okay. What he had written was, do you have a sample report? Would you like, Mr. Saibal, would you like to share your response for the same?
No. I don't have any right now sample report, but sure. If needed, Mr. Nair can contact Alvin Integrated Service. I will be happy to share the report, EIA report to him. Okay. But right now I cannot share it. Huh? So I would like to request Mr. Nair to contact Alvin Integrated Services for the EIA report, and I will be very happy to share it.
Thank you, Mr. Saibal. I move to the next question. That's from Mr. Ahmed Al-Bayati. If you would like to out your question, Mr. Ahmed, if you are with us right now. Okay, I'd read out his question if it's still not answered. In which stage of the project we should start the EIA? Also, do we need to... Okay.
Yes, first question is which
stage?
Which step?
Stage.
The stage. Yes, stage. It is, as I told, that the project, from the screening, screening means the starting of the project. Whether you have decided to make a factory on a certain place, that on the that strategic planning is done by the management to set up a project there. EIA report starts, EIA assessment starts from the beginning of the project, up to the end of the implementation stage.
Sure. Thank you. I'll move to his second part of his question, which says, also, do we need to include this social impact with the EIA?
Yeah, definitely the social impact, because the economical impact and the social impact is closely related with the human beings or the stakeholders or the interested party. So social and economic factor is to be taken care of when you go for a EIA.
Sure. He has a third part to his question, and it says, do you have some cases of projects that failed to follow EHSIA?
Yeah, this I have already told that Bhopal gas tragedy, example of Bhopal gas tragedy, and I think you all know in recent days, the 2020 or 2019 late, the Vizag, there is a very severe accident caused in a Vizag project where hundreds of people has died, and the project has to be closed because of that proper EIA study has not been done by the organization.
Sure. His last question states, what are the sizes of the projects that require EIA?
So it depends. There is no size and shape of the organization. Every organization can do the EIA, but it depends upon the how the their product or their activities affecting the environment. If their product or activity doesn't affect the environment, there is no EIA is required.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Saibal. I move to a question from Ms. Urmila Lihari. Ms. Urmila, would you like to voice out your question? Would you like to come on screen and unmute yourself?
Yeah. Yes. Good evening. My question is that what will be the criteria for the evaluation of the significant and non-significant impact?
Yeah. Okay. Good question. The significant. What is significant and what is non-significant? Non-significant and significant. Significant is the where the effect is much more much more serious and non-significant.
But how can we evaluate that is significant? I am
explaining you that significant and non-significant, you have to go for a aspect impact study first. There is okay. a process. There is a process in the in 14001 2015 standard. The clause number six. Clause number
6.1.2.
Yes, 6.1.2 is the aspect impact study. If you go for the aspect impact study and apply the controls, then you can mitigate the. You can differentiate the what is. Whether it, the aspects is the significant or non-significant.
Okay, yeah, it is up to or up to the organization to for the criteria evaluation for the significant.
Yes, every organization have their own criteria to decide whether this particular aspect is significant or non-significant. There is their own criteria depending upon their activity and the effect on the biodiversity. You have to take care of the on the flora, fauna, and land, water.
Yes,
suppose your pollution, suppose your organization is byproduct is a heavy metal, and okay. you are throwing this heavy metal in the soil, so it can affect
the land contamination.
Yeah. You got it. The contamination, soil contamination will there be there, and the after effect is the ground surface, not surface water, the groundwater will be affected.
Yes. Okay, got it, sir. Yeah, thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for asking the question, Urmila. I'm coming up screen. We had Mr. Bashir writing in a few points. Mr. Bashir, do you still have any question? Would you like to ask Mr. Sehgal right now? I will move further because I felt it's like a statement. So I move to the next question from Mr. Phonobong Moses. Moses, did I pronounce your name properly? Would you like to come in on screen and ask the question, Mr. Moses?
Yes, thank you so very much.
Thank you.
I actually had the answer in the course of his delivery. Thank you so much.
Are you clear with the question?
Yes, I am.
Yes,
public I actually engagement. Joined from the United Kingdom.
Thank you, Mr. Moses. In that case, I move to, again, I think there was a conversation between Mr. Ahmed and Bashir, so I don't think there's a question out here, but if any one of you would like to voice out any question, or else I'll move to the last question that I see on the chat box, which is from Mr. Sanjay Gore. Okay, so Mr. Sanjay has written whether pandemic like COVID, Mr. Sanjay, would you like to come up on screen and voice out your question?
Yeah.
Thank you.
It is pleasure to be with you people. And thank you for arranging this very nice program. My only question is whether pandemic, after declaration of pandemic, whether it can be considered as an environment and whether EAI will have some space for pandemic also.
Yes. The EIA is during this pandemic on this pandemic situation. It is a mandatory requirement for any organization to go for a EIA report on basis of the effect they have faced during this pandemic situation.
Yeah, good. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sanjay. I was very happy that you are with us.
Yeah. Very interesting.
So nice of you.
You need to welcome on our chop.
Yeah, and Elizabeth, I would like to ask participants to share their live feedback
exactly.
on this webinar conducted by the Alvin Integrated Service. Since this is the 11th webinar we are conducting, take some live feedback from the honorable participants for this webinar.
Thank you, Mr. Sehgal. We both are on the same page, and I was coming up to that. So it is really, really very important for us to know the feedback of all our valuable participants so that we can improve ourselves in our forthcoming webinar series. And we would request you to come on screen and speak up. Please, anyone who'd like.
This is Kingsley Michael.
Kingsley, please come on screen. We'd like to see you.
Okay. Am I visible? Am I visible? Yes, can I go ahead?
Yes, Kingsley. Let me pin you.
Okay. Mr. Saibal Gupta and Elizabeth George. This is Kingsley Michael. I want to appreciate your wonderful presentation, sir. It's highly informative, honestly. I have to suspend my job to attend this presentation, and I can say that I did not regret taking my time to attend your presentation. It's highly informative. I have been looking up to such a wonderful opportunity to know more about environmental impact assessments. I am a NABOSH certified environmental diploma holder, but yet I still need more on this environmental impact assessment, of which today I can say that I have gotten more information on this. So thank you so much for this presentation. That's opened my mind more on this. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Kingsley. It's a pleasure for us. I see a lot of comments on the chat box. May I request Mr. Dane Smith, would you like to give in your feedback among the audience? Hey, in that case, anyone else, we would really want you to come up on the screen. I can see Mr. Sanjay Sharma, Mr. Aslam Hussain writing in. Would you like to please come up on screen? If there is any constructive feedback, that's really valuable for us. Okay, in case everyone is interested in writing in their feedbacks, we appreciate your feedback. We appreciate your compliments. We would love to hear you. If there's any one person who'd like to speak, and if not, then I'd like to continue considering the importance of time. So before we disperse, I'd like to thank you on behalf of each member of Team AIS for attending today's session and for making this webinar successful. Thank you so much. For your information, Alvin Integrated Services is planning a full day event as Global ISO Knowledge Sharing Summit 2021 online on the 27th of February 2021. If you're interested to participate in the summit, please send your interests at trainings@alvinintegrated.com. Website registrations will be started shortly. It's a summit which you would learn a lot from. And once again, thank you, Mr. Saibal. And thank you to all our participants for joining in today and giving in your precious time. We hope to see you in our future sessions as well. And don't forget to share your feedbacks. It's really important for us to improve us better. And please note that your participation certificates would be sent to your registered email addresses by tomorrow. And kindly support our initiative and follow us on our LinkedIn page, Alvin Integrated Services. Please be safe and healthy. Once again, wishing a very happy new year to you and your families and a safe 2021. Have a great day ahead.
Thank you, Elizabeth.
Thank you, Moses.
Thank you, everyone. It was so nice to join. And I learned a whole lot. God bless. Bye.
Thank you, Moses. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you, Saibal. Thank you, Elizabeth. We thank all you. Learnt a lot, I think. Yes.
Thank you, Mr. Narahar.
Yeah. Narahar.
Narahar Deshpande. Thank you, Mr. Narahar. Sorry for the
error. No. Thank you very much. It was a very insightful and informative webinar, and I can see a lot of pain and effort has gone in preparing this particular presentation. So I like to thank Saibal sir on behalf of all of us.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. Deshpande.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
So thank you, Lisa, for your active participation in my webinar. I am very thankful to you that you have conducted so nicely my webinar. Okay, bye. Thank you very much, Lisa.
Thank you, Mr. Saibal. It was a great learning experience, and definitely thank you to AIS team. There are a lot of people working in the back end to make it all possible. Thank you, Sohan, and your team. Definitely. And with this webinar is declared as over for the day. Thank you all.
Thank you, Mr. Sanjay. Thank you, Mr. Saibal. Thank you so much. Thank you all the participants for joining today. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Elizabeth. And thank you, Dr. Gupta. Nice to meet you all. Take care.